afternoon, boys and girls. This is teacher Isaac again. How was school to you? Did you miss your classmates? After a long break, I am sure you missed them. Welcome once again to Sunshine Kids this afternoon. One more week will be Chinese New Year. For those who are celebrating Chinese New Year, you must be quite excited, very excited. And I'm sure you are looking forward to meet your relatives. This afternoon, we will hear Captain Jeshurun to share about another celebration, that is the celebration of Jesus' birth. The celebration will involve all of us. Before I go further, I would like to invite Jordan Lu to say the opening prayer. Jordan, it's all yours.
Dear Lord Jesus, thank you that today is the day that the Lord has made. We all will rejoice and be glad in it. I commit the worship team into your hands. I pray that all my friends here will enjoy the worship time. I pray for Uncle Jeshurun as he shares on the celebration of Jesus' birth. Help us to focus on what you want us to learn today. Give us a wonderful afternoon together. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Jordan, for the opening prayer. Shall we stand up to recite the three P's together? The first P, participate during praise and worship. The second P, pay attention during lesson. And the third P, ponder and think what God is saying to you. Good job! Let's welcome the worship team today as we celebrate our Lord Jesus.
Thank you. This next song is about coming into God's presence.
I love presents.
Me too. Well,
yeah. I love presents too, but I'm not talking about that kind of present. I'm talking about being in God's presence.
Come into the Holy of Holies. Enter by the blood of the Lamb. Come into His presence with singing. Worship at the throne of God. Come into the Holy of Holies. Enter by the blood of the Lamb. Come into His presence with singing. Worship at the throne of God.
Lift your hands.
Lifting.
SSK Sunshine Kids in a very new episode of our Sunday School. And I really hope that you can remember me, right? Can anyone recall me? What is my name? And you can remember me, my hat and everything, right? So my name is Captain Jash. And today, I hope you are really excited for a very new episode of our SSK. So it's 2022. We met last year, right? And in 2022, how have you guys been doing? How is school? So I mean, when you say new year, right, you're gonna go to new school, you're gonna go to a school, you're gonna go back to school. There's a lot of things that you need to go back to school. So how is your school experience? Are you excited to go and meet back your friends you never see for a long time? Or are you feeling scared to go back to school after so long? Or are you first time going to school, you're just excited? So whatever it is, I really hope that you go back to school, because there's a lot of things you can learn from school. So today, what we're going to do is, before I continue, right, I have a very special friend from you, all the way from different planet. Okay, I'm not sure where he is. His name is Captain Gupta. Let me call him. Captain Gupta, come in. Captain Gupta, where are you? Captain Gupta, where are you? Come in now.
Hello, hello, hello. Hello everybody, my name is Captain Gupta. I am from a different planet.
Okay, I know, but why did you take so long? The children are waiting for you. Do you know that's very important that you come on time and you do that? They are waiting for you.
Okay, I'm sorry. How are you children? My name is Captain Gupta. That's why I have a long black hair and a very long blue mouth. That's why. Hello everyone, nice to meet you.
Yes, the children are very excited. Children, can you say hi to my friend here by waving? Yes, very nice, very good. So today, children, I have a very specific topic me and Captain Gupta, Captain Jash and Captain Gupta want to share with you, which is the birth of Jesus Christ. What is our topic again?
The birth of Jesus Christ.
Yes, correct, the birth of Jesus Christ. So today, we're going to take from Luke chapter 1, verses 18 to 25. Okay?
Luke chapter 1, verse 18 to 25.
Okay, so just open your Bibles with me, okay? So the verse says in Luke chapter 1, verse 18 to 25, right? I'll take the important points for you that you can read. So when Jesus, when Mary was conceived, right? When Mary maybe Jesus was in Mary's womb. So Joseph actually took Mary as his wife. And as he took as his wife, right, when Jesus come into the world, Jesus will come into, verse 22 says, all this took place to fulfill what the Lord says through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and it will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. Gupta, do you know Emmanuel means God is with us?
No, I didn't know that. This is the first time I'm seeing. Because they said in verse 21 itself said, she will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from all their sins.
Yes, correct, Gupta. So Jesus will come to this world. Actually, Jesus' parents, the name is Mary and Joseph. Okay, so Mary and Joseph. How did Mary, Mary got conceived via a spirit, and then Joseph got married to Mary, and then after that, the baby Jesus was born. So why did Jesus come into this world? Why did Jesus come into the world? Yes, verse 21 says, Jesus come into the world to save his people from sins. So, what when you mean by sins actually? Let's say, right, children, you and me. Today, right, Gupta, if you lie to your parents, if you say something wrong, if you're angry or whatever it is, right, it is like you are actually doing a sin. But Jesus comes to forgive our sins. Do you know that?
Oh, Jesus come to wash us. Wash our sins.
Yes, Jesus come to wash our sins, children. But when you want Jesus to wash your sin, let's say you're feeling that, oh, I did this mistake, or I scold my friend, or I'm angry with my son, but Jesus wants to forgive your sin. But how do Jesus forgive your sin is when you say, Jesus, forgive my sins that I have done, and make me pure. And Jesus will wash and cleanse your sins away. Yes, children, so Jesus come into this world not as an ordinary child, but as a savior to save you and me and everyone else from our sins. That is number one. Number two, Jesus also come into this world to give us hope. Gupta, do you know what is this hope, right?
I don't know. Maybe you can tell me more about this hope. This hope is like maybe we don't have a hope for tomorrow, but I don't know.
Yes, children, this hope that Jesus bring to you is a hope that maybe you think that, oh, I'm going through this challenge. I have no one to help me. I am struggling in this. Jesus is there for you. Jesus will give you this hope that do not worry. Whatever worriness you have in heart, maybe you are having fear, you are having scared, you are having worriness in your heart. Children, whatever worriness that you have, Jesus is telling that he is your hope and he will take away the worriness from your heart. Amen. Jesus will take away the worriness. So, how many points we learned so far? Number one is,
Jesus will wash away your sins.
And number two is,
Jesus will give you a new hope. Yay!
Yes, children. And the third point that I want to share with you is in verse, as I shared just now, in verse 23, the virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, children. So what is this Emmanuel mean? Emmanuel means God is with us, children. So today Jesus is telling Emmanuel, God is with you. Wherever you are now, you're watching this, wherever you're watching this, with your parents, with your brothers, with your sisters, or with your friend, Jesus is telling God is with you. When you're sleeping at night, God is with you. When you're going to school, God is with you. Wherever you go, whatever you do, you just remember Emmanuel, meaning
God is with you.
Yes, God is with you, which means Emmanuel. So children, so the next point, let's see. So, and then Jesus actually came into this world and he actually gave us these main three things that you and I will actually experience a different life, okay? So today, children, no more fear, no more sadness, and no more things that you should worry. Because number one, Jesus come to wash away your sins. Today, you and I are a new child in Christ, and you and I are no more sinners because Jesus has washed away our sin. Number two, whatever you worry, maybe you're thinking, oh, tomorrow, what is going to happen? Tomorrow, I'm going to go to school. How is the school is? But do not worry, because why? Jesus come to give you hope. And number three, Jesus says that He comes to give, He's always with you. And what is the word, children, again? It starts with Emmanuel. Yes, correct, Emmanuel. Gupta, yes. You see, our children are very good, right? You see, they are very awesome. You always remember things. So remember, children, Jesus come to wash away your sins, give you hope, and last, He's Emmanuel. He is with you. So whenever you go far from anywhere, go to the school, go to anywhere, just remember, God, be with me today. Be with me today. Help me in your studies, in your whatever things that you do, where you are weak, you're thinking that I can't do it, just say, God, help me. Emmanuel, God, you are with me. Help me, God. And Jesus will give you the strength to do it. Amen. So children, to Jesus Christ who come into this world, He born into this world, today Jesus, that same Jesus, when you call Him into your heart, when you call Him to your heart, He will do all these things for you. He will just, as how He come to this world, He brought a light, as a light come to this world, right? Imagine like how a light come, Gupta, do you know like a light come? When you switch on a light in a dark room, immediately it will be bright. Just like that, Jesus come into our life will be shining, children. Our life will be like a star shining. Our life will be like a star shining. And that, children, today, that Jesus wants to come into your life. Jesus wants to make a big difference in your life. Okay, what you have to do is very easy. Okay, you don't have to do so many things. You just say this prayer with me, and Jesus will do this thing in your life. Okay, let's close your eyes wherever you are. Just close your eyes and let's pray together. Me and Gupta will pray, and you just follow the prayer with me. Okay, let's pray. Dear Jesus, say after me. Dear Jesus, forgive my sins. Sorry for not for all the things, the wrong things that I've done in my life. Sorry for sometimes I never follow what or never be an obedient child. Sorry if I have scolded any of my friends. Sorry if sometimes I've been a naughty child. Dear Jesus, wash away my sins. Cleanse me to make me cleanse my life. Make me white as snow. And today, Jesus, that as you come into my life will no longer be the same. That today, my sins are forgiven. I will have hope in you. And number three, that you, Emmanuel, that you are with us. You are in my life. Dear Jesus, I pray that my life will be a blessing to someone. As your light come into my life, I pray that today I'm inviting you, Jesus, to come into my life, that my life will never be the same. My life is for you, Lord Jesus. I pray and ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. So children, so today as you accept Jesus into your life, you must have, always must have the peace, love and joy. Remember, there's always that you are no more the same. Do not worry, because Jesus come to give you hope. Yes, Gupta, do not worry. And remember, Jesus has washed away your sins. Today you are a new creation in Christ. And the last, the most important thing as well, Jesus is with you. Okay, so do not worry. I pray that God bless you as you go to your school or do whatever. You will always have that love, joy and peace. Correct, right, Gupta? Yes, yes, yes. Okay, so children, we take care, and I will see you next one, because Gupta needs to go back to his planet and I need to go and continue to save many more people out there. One day I hope that you can join me and we can go and save many more people out there in our mission. Okay, so God bless you. Bye. Bye.
Wow, what an exciting message on the celebration on the birth of Christ Jesus. Next two Sundays, we will not be having any online services. We shall resume the online service on 13th of February. So check us out at Facebook for more updates. I will see you then. Bye-bye.